Are you looking to collect payments somehow online? Well, if so, you are going to love this video because I'm going to be showing you how to build a payment collection system using a simple form, Stripe, and storing that information in an Airtable backend. If learning more about this is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Hey, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission to help you unlock the full potential of no-code tools, meaning that we want to enable you to build cool stuff online without needing to know how to code. If you're curious about learning more about this and what you see in this video, I first want to invite you to join me for some free training. We put together an automation training that's going to teach you the basics of no-code automation. You can sign up for that training at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. I'll include links for that training wherever you found this video. But without further ado, let's go ahead and hop on into the heart of things here. We are going to be looking at building a form in Fillout, collecting payment inside of Stripe, and then putting that data into Airtable so that we can take action on it. Now, the key takeaway here, why would you put this data in Airtable? It's because we want to build a single source of truth. We don't want to have to log into Stripe to see payments and log into some other system to check our deal flow and log into another system to see our financials. We're putting everything in one place, and that's the whole point of using a tool like an Airtable, and Fillout's going to make the whole data collection so much simpler. So let's go ahead and hop on into my screen. I'm starting inside of Airtable here. You can see I set up a database. I've called it payment collection, and I don't have any fields built just yet. I actually want to start with the form in this case. So I'm going to flip over into Fillout. Now, if you don't already have a Fillout account, please consider signing up using our affiliate link that I'll share with this video. It's a great way for you to show some love back to the channel. But not only is Fillout an amazing tool for collecting form data, they also have this awesome new payment integration that I'm going to be featuring here. So we're going to say make a Fillout. Go ahead and follow along with me in your own account. You can see that we have the option of setting up a payment form right from the get-go. So let's go ahead and set this up. I'll make the selection here. I can pick from one of the predisposed themes here. Let's go with the futuristic theme. Give us that, and we'll create our payment form. Now, we are already starting with a checkout piece on our form. We can name the form. I'll call this example so that I know in the future that it was used for this. And let's move on to the next step. So we've already connected our Stripe account with this Fillout setup, but we might want to change how we've selected it here. So let's actually connect a new account. I'll connect to Stripe and you'll see how simple it is to get this all set up. It's going to take just a moment to talk and we can then select from our different Stripe accounts that we have here, make the selection and then opt to connect. So setting up a new account is that simple. I just make the selection here. You of course have to be signed into a Stripe account. Stripe accounts are easy to set up, free to you. You'll only pay after you start processing payments. They'll take a piece of every transaction. So we're going to go ahead and make the selection here, say connect, and we're good to go. Now, also inside of Stripe, I would recommend bringing this up on your screen as well, and be sure to go into test mode because we're going to be testing this. We want to make sure that we can send in some fake transaction data, collect that information. We don't want it to be collecting actual live data just yet. So now we have our product, we have our form built, and we can see that we take the credit card number, we take the expiration, the CVC, the country, the zip code, and we can edit our product. So this is where you can describe the particular product you're selling on this form. If you had other pages in the form where people are making selections, you can actually reference that data here. So maybe they picked something to buy and then you're adding it to the cart. You can have that kind of functionality here. But for us, let's just say we sell a t-shirt. So I'll just go in and type that in. That'll be static data. We can add a description, alter the price, and upload an image here. I'll go with this image, just the default here, and we'll say done. So that's how this is going to show up. This is where I edited that data. You can see that right on the form itself. We can add other pages to our form. There are a number of different page types. We can collect other information. We can add a cover page. We can alter the ending page. We can add a review, so let them review their submission before it's complete. We already have the payment element. That's what we have right now. And we can also set up a login page in Fillout, so they have to be logged in before they can actually do the next step. And then another brand new feature from Fillout, adding scheduling to a form. So if we were selling an hour or time or something along those lines, we could even include that in our form as well. So lots of different options up front. But for us, we want to really look at the payment section. So let's keep this simple. We'll take a deeper dive now at the other section here. So we've already looked at the product, but let's also look at the payment type. Note that you can set up subscriptions, which are great for recurring payments. And we can also set up a pay what you want. This is perfect if you're taking things like tips, or maybe you have a minimum threshold. You say you have to spend at least $5, but if you find more value in this, you could buy more or pay us more. So there are a lot of options for us, but the most common is probably going to be that one-time payment that we have selected. Now we can collapse this and look at the payment itself. We can allow for discount codes. So if we toggle this on, we can go into Stripe and set up a discount code that allows our users to then add a discount code if they have it, and it will reduce either a percentage or a fixed dollar amount from the final total here. We can also collect email. This is highly, highly valuable, especially if you want to keep track of customers. So if this customer has already made a purchase from you, they already have a Stripe object, a customer object inside of Stripe. And this way, all future payments that they make in this form are going to be credited to that same customer. Rather than creating a guest user in Stripe, which is very cumbersome, and a lot of software tends to use the guest checkout element, Fillout has gone above and beyond and is allowing you to make sure that you're connecting that Stripe customer, which is all tied to that Stripe customer email. We can also pre-fill fields. So if we have data that lives in other parts of our form, we can pre-fill that information. This is particularly useful if we want to fill out the email address on behalf of the client because we already know that information, for example. Now, into payment methods, highly recommend checking out the different methods available. Card is going to be set by default. We might also go with link, and this is great if someone's made payments with us before. They don't have to enter their information over and over again. We can also look at Affirm and then also a US bank account transfer or an ACH payment. This is great because it's going to lower the fees that we pay to Stripe based on the transaction volume. Okay, we can also go into appearance. This is where we can set up the button text and alter that. Right now it's set to the default, pay X dollars. And we can also show a testimonial down here, and we can edit that as needed if we want to include that element. And then after payment, what happens? We can toggle on to send a Stripe receipt. And of course, we're also going to go to the final page when they have submitted the data. They're going to go to the payment success page, and we can set this up to say something else like thank you for your payment, check email for next steps or something along those lines. So we have all of this control on our new payment form that we created and fill out. When we're happy with the way we've established it, let's go ahead and publish this, of course, and now copy this, and we're going to access in a new window the form that we just created. So here it is. You can see that we have our link already established. It knows me because I've used this browser before. We can go ahead and type in our information. And this is now going to assign us to that user back inside of Stripe. Now let's collect some real data. I'll actually pay myself the $10 here. It's going to go right back to me minus the transaction fee, so I'm not too worried about spending the 10 bucks for this example. So first we'll go back into Stripe and we'll toggle off test mode so that we can be sure to actually collect the real data. Now back into Fillout, and we will go ahead and select our payment. You see that because we toggled on the link capability, it already has my credit card information stored here, making it so easy for me to pay. And now, just like that, I can click pay and my data will be received. So now I have this information. Once the payment goes through, I'll go to the final page. If the payment is declined, I get a warning on the previous page and I don't get to complete the transaction. But now for the important part. Yeah, great, we built the form, we collected the payment in Stripe, but you need the data in Airtable. Let's build it. So back inside of Fillout now, we'll go back to our form itself, and let's take a look at the information that we just received. We have results now, and we can go in here and see the different data that we collected. This is the link to our Stripe. If we open this up, we're gonna see that this particular user just made this payment for $10 in our account, and we're gonna see that very payment. Here they are, all that data right here. We see the fee that we paid to Stripe. We see the net amount that we collected. All of this information is right here. So what can we do with this? let's go back into Fillout now and actually go to the integrations. So when we are setting this up, if we say, hey, we want to actually create a record in Airtable, we can do just that. So find the right Airtable account if you've integrated multiple, or if you have not yet integrated, connect a new account to Fillout. From here, we're going to select that. Now we get to choose what database we want to write this information to. If you don't see the right database here, you need to refresh or reconnect that base. Just follow the on-screen prompts. But here I am. I want to sync up with payment collection. And then what table do I want to write this data to? Now for Fillout, a native integration between Fillout and Airtable only writes to or updates to one table. We cannot write data to multiple tables using the native integration or connection. If you want to do that, which I highly recommend, check out no-code automation tools like Zapier and or make.com, which allow us to take the information we collect from Fillout and spread it among multiple tables. But with the native integration, we're going to write to one table and one table only. So we only have the one table back in our Airtable database. We only have one table called table one, and we don't really have any fields built out for this quite yet. So let's continue and take a look. We want to create a record when the form is collected and add that record right to Airtable immediately. So let's go into mappings. What different information are we collecting from the payment form? Well, that lives right here in the checkout of the payment inside of Fillout. So we can go in and we can look at the amount paid, the email used, the currency, the Stripe customer ID, the Stripe payment ID. All of this information can be written back to Airtable. So let's take a moment to create all these fields in Airtable, and then we can map them appropriately. All right, now that we created those fields in Airtable, let's go on back now to Fillout, and we need to refresh this information. So right here, we'll say, hey, we're gonna map to all those Airtable fields. Let's refresh that Airtable connection so that you know about the new fields we've built. Now, we can go into our fields and find them here. These fields now exist in Airtable, amount paid in Airtable. Let's go here, map it to amount paid in Fillout. We're going to do that now for all the fields that we got in the checkout form. Now that we have everything mapped, let's go ahead and finish our setup here, and we're going to test this one more time. We're going to publish it. We're going to go back to our live example by clicking on share and opening up the form in a new tab, and let's do it one more time. I'm going to fill out my information. And once we have that typed in, we're going to pay again. This is live, so I'm actually paying the $10 here. But again, it's going to just get credited right back to me. No problem. For the most part, less a few cents. Let's make that payment and now flip into Airtable to watch it get received. So once Fillout processes the payment, you can see all of that information stored right here. We have the payment amount, $10. We have the email, we have the currency, we have the Stripe customer ID, the payment ID, and perhaps most importantly, the ability to go right to that customer inside of Stripe or right to that payment URL. We can just open it up. Now all that data lives in our source of truth, Airtable, but we can instantly pick it up and go right to where we need to in order to access the active data. Now, I know we went really fast in this video. There's a lot to cover. If you want to see more advanced integrations where we're connecting payment processing through Fillout, Stripe, and Zapier as well, let me know in the chat below. Or if you have other questions about what we did here, be sure to reach out as well. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching. And in the meantime, keep on building.